हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर स्टडिंग अबाउट द फंडामेंटल यूनिट ऑफ लाइफ। द फंडामेंटल यूनिट ऑफ life, the fundamental unit of life, and this fundamental unit of life today we have to study about nucleus, about we have to study about the nucleus is an important structure, and nucleus consists of nuclear membrane. First we have to make a diagram of nucleus. So nucleus consists of one structure is given here. This is nuclear membrane. So first structure, it is a nucleus consists of, number one is nuclear membrane. So this is nuclear membrane. So two membranes are there. This is outer this is inner, and this is this is the structure of nuclear membrane. This is nuclear membrane. This is outer membrane and inner membrane, and in between the outer membrane and the inner membrane there is a space, and this space is called the perinuclear space. And after that you see here one more structure, This is called as nuclear pore. This structure is called as nuclear pore. Nuclear pore. Then we can make this structure here. We can make this structure here. So by which it will be easy for us in labeling. This structure is nuclear pore. Nuclear pore. This structure. This is nuclear membrane. This is consists of two membranes, outer membrane and the inner membrane. The space is found in between the outer and inner membrane. Is called as the perinuclear space, and this nuclear membrane have many pores. These pores are called as the nuclear pore. This nuclear pore makes cytoplasmic connection with cytoplasm. You have studied the structure of this cell. This is the cell, and inside this nucleus is there. And this you draw diagram. This is cytoplasm. Cytoplasm is here. So this is nucleus is there. So the materials, movement of material takes place in between the nucleus and the cytoplasm via nuclear pore. So nuclear pore makes cytoplasmic connection with the nucleus. Next, after nuclear membrane, next structure you have to see. A fluid is filled here. And this fluid is called as the nucleoplasm. This fluid is called as the nucleoplasm. Fluid filled here, this is called as the as cytoplasm. You have studied in the same way, nucleoplasm is there. So one is nuclear membrane. Next, it is vertical nuclear pore, you can say. Second, nucleoplasm, it is here. And after nucleoplasm, next structure is chromatin. Third is, we have to write here, that is third structure is chromatin. And fourth structure is nucleolus. This constitutes the this structure. Sometimes one nucleolus, most of the cases only one nucleolus is found. So after that, some third-like structures may also be seen here. So this structure is called the chromatin. Chromatin and this structure, which is red in color, this structure is known as nucleolus. This structure is called the nucleolus. So this is the structure of nucleus. You see here one chromatin. This is very important part of the cell. This chromatin during cell division condense and thick. Now it is called as the chromosome. It is called as chromosome. It is called the chromatin. It is a thread-like structure, and during cell division, this chromatin become condensed, and now it is called the chromosome. Chromosome is formed of two components. Chromosome is part of two components. These components are, number one, DNA, and second is protein. Chromosome is part of DNA and protein. DNA means deoxyribonucleic acid. DNA means deoxyribonucleic acid. This is deoxyribonucleic acid, and you are familiar to name as the genes. So genes is the functional unit of DNA. So the one more term, genes. What is gene? That is the functional. It is the functional segment of gene. Functional segment of DNA. This structure, which is functional structure of DNA, it is called genes. Genes carry the characters from one generation to next generation. Now in some cells, nucleus is not well defined. There is no well defined nuclear region. There is no nuclear membrane In some organisms like bacteria, nuclear membrane is absent. They do not have well-defined nucleus. Nuclear region consists of only nucleic acid and called as nucleoid. So in some organisms like bacteria, the nuclear membrane is absent and they do not have the well-defined the nucleus. It is represented by only the DNA and defined by the nucleic acid and called as nucleoid. Such organisms are called as the prokaryotes. Prokaryotes and others having well-defined nucleus is called as the eukaryotes. So two type of organisms are there, prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Organism having the well-defined nucleus are called as the eukaryote, just like here. And organisms do not have the well-defined nucleus. Nucleus is called as the nucleoid. Such organisms are prokaryotes. So next time we discuss in detail about the difference between prokaryotes and the eukaryotes. Thank you. That's for today only.